Though their names may not ring bells like that of Ted Bundy, Jeffrey Dahmer, and John Wayne Gacy, these 10 men have committed crimes that were just as vile and sinister as the monsters previously mentioned. Let's take a closer look at 10 black serial killers of our time. Coming in at number 10, we have one of the most prolific serial killers in Los Angeles history, Chester Dwayne Turner. On April 20th, 2007, he was convicted of 10 counts of murder and found guilty of the murder of one of his victim's unborn child. All of his murders occurred between 1987 and 1998, with all of them happening within a 30-block radius of where he lived. He was known for raping and strangling his victims. Turner was jailed multiple times between 1995 and 2002 for 9 violent crimes before his last incarceration for sexually assaulting a 47-year-old woman for over 2 hours on Skid Row led to him getting caught. Turner was required to give a DNA sample, and in 2003, he was connected to the murders of Paula Vance, 38, and Mildred William Beasley, 45. This would lead to detectives examining Turner closer and realizing his DNA matched other unsolved cases. This would include Diane Johnson, who was 21 at the time of her death, Annette Ernest, 26, Anita Fisherman, 31, Regina Washington, 27, Desiree Jones, 29, Andrea Triplett, 29, Natalie Price, 31, and Brenda Breeze, 37. He was later convicted of an additional 4 murders in 2014 when DNA tests connected him to another 4 victims. He is currently on death row at San Quentin State Prison awaiting execution for 14 counts of murder. At number 9, we have the Kansas City Strangler, Lorenzo Gilliard. In 2007, he was convicted of 6 counts of murder, though his DNA showed that he raped and murdered 13 women between 1977 and 1993. Gilliard was known for targeting sex workers, and just like Chester Turner, he would rape and strangle his victims. He had already served a sentence for child molestation and was even suspected of rape while on probation from 1969 to 1974, but he was never charged with those crimes. Detectives began looking at Gilliard in 1987 for the murder of Sheila Ingold, in which he voluntarily gave a DNA test. That would come back to bite him 15 years later because he was linked to 13 other victims. He was convicted on 6 counts of murder for Catherine Berry, 34, Naomi Kelly, 23, Ann Barnes, 36, Kelly Ford, 20, Sheila Ingold, 36, Carmeline Hibbs, 30. But the other cases were not brought to court, which included Stacy Swafford, 17, Gwendolyn Kazine, 15, Margaret Miller, 17, Debbie Blevins, 32, Helga Kruger, 26, and Connie Luther, 29. He was acquitted for the murder of Angela Mayhew due to insufficient evidence. Gilliard is currently serving out his life sentence at the Crossroads Correctional Center in Missouri. Anthony Sowell, also known as the Cleveland Strangler, takes the number 8 spot. Like our previous counterparts, he also targeted sex workers and, in this case, drug addicts. In 2009, 11 murdered women were found at his home in Cleveland, Ohio, and in 2011, he was convicted for those 11 victims, including other charges for his crimes. He was additionally convicted for attempted murder of 3 victims who was fortunate enough to escape. Sowell had already served a 15-year sentence for rape and had been free for a couple of years before a new rape investigation led police to his home, where they found 2 decomposing bodies. He was arrested on the spot, and as the investigation continued, officials found other victims who had already decomposed in various locations throughout the property. His surviving victims said he was a sweet man that turned into a monster once they got into his house. They even claimed they went to the police, who did not believe them. Officials say he was able to lure these women due to their addictions, and unfortunately, it led to their untimely demise. Anthony Sowell died at 61 from a terminal illness, evading the death sentence for his gruesome crimes. Henry Louis Wallace, also known as the Charlotte Strangler and Taco Bell Strangler, was convicted for killing 9 women on January 7, 1997, though he actually killed 11. He knew all of his victims personally, and all of the women are said to have been in the fast food industry. Wallace had previously been arrested for numerous crimes, including rape at gunpoint. He was arrested in February 1994 for shoplifting, and by this time, he had already raped and strangled 5 women. But for some reason, he did not pop up on police radars. 1993 was a rough year for Charlotte Police Department, as it was deemed the deadliest year in Charlotte's history, with over 300 deaths taking place that year. At the time, police did not have enough evidence to link anyone to the cases or to link the cases together. Wallace was caught after he murdered Deborah Ann Slaughter. Her body was found on March 12, 1994, and Wallace was arrested on March 13th, where he confessed to all of the murders. Charlotte Police Department faced a lot of backlash for not catching Wallace much sooner. Shauna Denise Hogg's mother, Dee Sumter, said, "The victims weren't prominent people with social economic status. They weren't special, and they were Black." In 1993, Dee Sumter founded the organization Mothers of Murdered Offspring, which is a program that gives support to families who have lost their children to violence. Wallace's victims include Tashonda Bethia, 18, Sharon Nance, 33, Shauna Hawk, 20, Audrey Spain, 33, Alencia Jumper, 21, Michelle Stinson, 20, Vanessa Mack, Brandy Henderson, 18, Betty Bakum, 24, Deborah Slaughter, 35, and Caroline Love. Wallace is currently incarcerated in Raleigh, North Carolina on death row. At number 6, we have Benjamin Atkins, also known as the Woodward Corridor. He killed 11 women over a 9-month span in the Highland Park, Detroit area. Atkins mostly targeted sex workers, as he despised the profession, and all of his victims were raped, strangled, and left in abandoned buildings. During trial, it came out that Atkins was molested at the age of 10, and his mother was also a sex worker, which is where his hate stemmed from. His victims included Darlene Saunders, 35, Debbie Ann Friday, 30, Bertha Jean Mason, 26, Patricia Cannon George, 36, Vicky Truelove, 39, Valerie Chalk, 34, Juanita Hardy, 23, Brenda Mitchell, 38, Vicky Beasley Brown, 43, Joanna O'Rourke, 40, Osanina Waymar, 22, and an unknown female who they found at the Monterey Hotel in Highland Park. Atkins received 11 consecutive life sentences, but died 4 years into his sentence due to HIV. At number 5, we have the grim sleeper, Lonnie Franklin Jr., who was arrested in 2010, but convicted in 2016 for killing 9 women and a child. He is suspected to have actually killed 25 women over a 20-year period. Franklin got his name, the Grim Sleeper, because he was said to be a quiet and friendly guy that no one would have ever suspected of murder. Franklin was also another serial killer who targeted sex workers. Franklin was caught when police found a similar DNA match in their system to the ones found at the crime scenes. This match would come from Franklin's son, who was at the time arrested on a weapons felony charge. They used this to match DNA found on a piece of pizza that belonged to Franklin, which connected him to the murders. Franklin's victims included Deborah Jackson, 29, Henrietta Wright, 34, Thomas Steele, 36, Barbara Ware, 23, Bernita Sparks, 26, Mary Lowe, 26, Latrika Jefferson, 22, Alice Monique Alexander, 18, Princess Berthamew, 15, Valerie McCorvey, 35, Anicia Peters, 25, and Anitra Margaret Washington, who was attacked in November 1988 and is the only known survivor. Franklin died while awaiting execution in 2020. He was found dead in a cell. Foul play was not suspected, though the cause of his death was unclear. Known as the most feared serial killer, Wayne Williams takes the number 4 spot. Williams was arrested in 1982 for the murders of 2 men, Jimmy Rain and Nathaniel Cater. He was just 23 at the time of his last murder, and he was suspected of killing more than 20 people. But what really got people talking about Williams was the fact that they believed he was responsible for the Atlanta child murders, in which 28 children was murdered without mercy. Police believed he was the main suspect in the murders of the children because after he was arrested, the murder stopped. Wayne was arrested after fibers found that his home and his car and other personal places was matched to both Cater and Rain. The city of Atlanta reached out to the FBI to help aid in the children's murder cases, but no one was ever convicted of those murders. Williams has maintained his innocence, which many believe since he is the son of two teachers. Many people believe the Atlanta child murders were pushed on Williams to cover up the fact that the Ku Klux Klan members may have had something to do with it. A KKK member by the name of Charles Sanders was originally investigated for a role in the murders. In 2005, it was revealed that in 1981, Sanders had told an informant for the Georgia Bureau of Investigation that the killer had wiped out 1,000 future generations of niggers. Police stopped looking at Sanders after him and his brother passed a lie detector test. The child murders are still unsolved to this day, and Williams was given 2 consecutive life sentences, which he is serving in Telfar State Prison in Helena, Georgia. Mari Troy Travis, most known as the videotape killer, comes in at number 3. Altogether, Travis was found to have killed 12 women who were said to be sex workers in the St. Louis area between 2000 and 2002. Mari was caught after he mailed a letter praising the slaying of one of his victims and a map marked with an X to a Post-Dispatch reporter. Police found skeletal remains of a woman at the location. Once police realized the map came from Expedia.com, they worked with Microsoft and WorldCom Internet Division to track the map back to Travis. He was arrested on June 7, 2002 and charged with 2 federal counts of kidnapping. Police found videotapes in the wall which showed the torture he inflicted on his victims, along with items from his victims in his basement. Though he was never convicted, he was suspected of killing Mary Shields, 61, Alyssa Greenway, 34, Teresa Wilson, 36, Betty James, 46, Verona Thompson, 36, Yvonne Cruz, 50, Brenda Beasley, 33, and 4 other unidentified women. Unfortunately, Travis will be found hanging in his cell on June 10, 2002, before he could be convicted of his crimes. Coming in at number 2, we have the infamous Carl Eugene Watts, who is known as a Sunday morning slasher and considered one of the most prolific serial killers of his time. He is suspected of killing more than 100 women, which is where he gets his title of most prolific. Watts began his life of crime at just 20 years old, and he was said to have kidnapped and tortured his victims before killing them. Until 1981, Watts had lived in Michigan, where he was suspected of killing at least 10 women and girls, but he soon moved to Texas after he grew tired of being interrogated by the police. Watts was arrested on May 23, 1982 for breaking into the home of 2 women and attempting to murder them. The same day, another woman was found drowned at her home, which police connected to Watts. Since Watts couldn't be tied to any of the other murders, he took a plea bargain to confess to his crimes in order to avoid a murder charge that would have carried a death sentence. He ended up confessing to attacking 19 women and killing 30. By the time the investigation was over, Watts admitted to killing over 80 women. In 1982, Watts was sentenced to 60 years, but due to a mistake the judge made, Watts' sentence was reduced and he could have been released in 2006. But in 2004, the Attorney General in Michigan was not letting up as he begged someone to come forward to keep Watts from being released. A witness by the name of Joseph Foy came forward and said he'd seen a man fitting Watts' description murder Helen Dutcher. Watts was convicted of the murder of Helen Dutcher, and on December 7, 2004, he was sentenced to life in prison. It was hard to catch Watts using DNA because he committed his crimes in different jurisdictions and states. It was said he was never sexually involved with his victims, which also made it hard to convict him on DNA. After receiving his life sentence, Watts died 3 years later from prostate cancer. He is by far one of the most gruesome killers on our list. Now, for the number one spot, we have the deadliest serial killer in the history of the United States, Samuel A. Little. Little confessed to killing 93 people, mostly women, between 1970 and 2005. Out of the 93 victims he claimed to have killed, he was officially connected to 60 of them, but of those 60, he was only charged with 8. He mostly targeted sex workers, drug addicts, and homeless women because he felt they would not be noticed missing. And unfortunately, he was right. Little killed for over 40 years, despite being arrested multiple times for charges such as murder and kidnapping, strangling, and beating a 22-year-old woman. In 2012, he was arrested at a homeless shelter in Louisville, Kentucky for a narcotics charge and extradited back to California where a DNA sample was taken. He was linked to the murders of 3 women and convicted for those crimes on September 25, 2014. Just a couple of years later, in 2018, he began confessing to his murders. It was a shock to find that many of his victims' deaths were ruled as accidental or overdoses, and many of these women still have not been found or identified. Little died in a California hospital in 2020. His death is uncertain, but he was said to have diabetes, heart troubles, and other health issues. Unfortunately, there are too many victims to list everyone, but I have put links in the description for anyone who would like to look into the matter further. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to like and subscribe, and I thank you all for watching.